In this tutorial, I will show you how to create a project in MDK-Keil. The textbook focuses on two different STM32 Discovery Kits, STM32L1 and STM32L4. STM32L1 has a Cortex-M3 microprocessor, while STM32L4 has a Cortex-M4 with FPU and DSP. In this tutorial, I will create a project for the STM32L4 Discovery Kit. Let's open MDK-Keil. The first step is to make sure that the required packages has already been installed. Click Packet Installer. Let's go to ST and ST32L4. We need at least three different packages: STM32L4 DFP, ARM CMSIS, and Keil MDK middleware. And if a package is missing, you can simply click the install button. It automatically download and install the package. Now let's create a new project. Click Project, New Project. Let's go to select a project folder. Let me create a new folder called Example Project. Select folder, give a project name, they just called project. Click Save. Now we need to select the device. We have to select STM32, L4, and 476VG, and select this device, this microprocessor. Click OK. In the runtime environment dialog, we need to select one software component called CMSIS call. Make sure do not select the startup package, startup assembly file here, because we're going to use a modified version that can be downloaded from the book website. So do not select this one. Click OK. Let's go to the textbook website. Go to textbook website, click the example labs, and the textbook website provides the project templates for different development boards. So we're focusing on STM32L4 in this tutorial, and we create a C project templates. Let's download the startup. Right click, save link as, save in the project folder, and save the head file. Let's go back to the project. Let's highlight the project's group, source group, right click, add existing file in the project. Let's select assembly, select startup, close. So now we have startup here. Let's create a new file, C code, add a new file, select C. Let's call it main, add. Let's write this C code. In this C code, we're not doing anything but just have a dead loop here. and including the header file we download, and it's called STM32L476XX.h, and let's write the main function. Make sure add a new line at end file. Have just a dead loop here. Save the file. Now we need to change the project properties. So let's go to options for the targets. And we can verify that we select the right device. This is the S-Cortex-M4 processor used on the Discovery Kit. And let's go to output. You can highlight create hex. This is useful if you want to download the hex file by using ST utility. But this is optional. In the linker page, make sure this is selected and this is selected by default. And in the debug environment, there are two different debug options. One is use simulator, the other one use hardware debug. And the simulator has some limitations. And for example, two major limitations are you cannot access all the peripherals. And the second one is all simulations can only assume ideal conditions for memory access, so it does not simulate a memory delay. And the other one is hardware debug, and the default is SULink2, and we're going to use STLink debugger. We click setting. So this has already been selected, and make sure the port, there are two options here, is JTAG and serial wire. Make sure we select the serial wire. And now another important thing is if you go to flash, make sure the flash memory has been selected. If the flash memory is not there, you can click add. You can select the flash memory. Since it's already there, I'm going to cancel it. I'm going to click OK. Now I can click the build project. You can build project by here. You can build target, or simply click this one, the icon here, build. Now have no errors. I can set a breakpoint to debug the code. This one, insert the breakpoint, and this is the debug icon. I click debug. Now you can see the program runs, stop at the breakpoint, and this is all the registers value. Register R0 to register 15, and program status registers including NGCV flags and FPU registers here. In the next tutorial, I'll show you how to debug a project.